Hi everyone and welcome back, it's Vicky here, and today we are going to take a close-up look on what's included in the new Tonic Craft Kit, and I'm also going to share some ideas. The kit once again is packed with products, and I strongly believe that is one of the best in the market. Now, first of all, it comes with this Nouveau mousse, and this is the new expanding mousse. I'm going to open it up for you so you can see the color. This is called Hammered Copper and it has this gorgeous copper color. I'm going to apply it on this piece of paper. You can apply it with brush, you can apply it with your fingers. There are different brushes that you can use. Now this is called expanding mousse because when you apply it and then you heat set it, it's going to bubble up on you, it's going to give a gorgeous texture, which I'm going to demonstrate in a card later in this video. But of course you can apply it just like a normal embellishment mousse with your finger or a brush. And it goes beautifully both on white as well as on black cardstock. And it gives you this gorgeous shine. Plus, it is really easy to clean your fingers just with a baby wipe and it doesn't stain them. Now, don't throw this foil, just use it inside the pot and press it towards the product. Make sure that you get a good contact, this way you eliminate the amount of fur that touches the product and it's going to stay nice and soft and prevent drying. You also get a diamond ink pad, this is acorn brown color, and I'm going to show you how it looks, a lovely brown chocolate color. And actually there is a whole range of these ink pads, they are hybrid inks, which means that you can use them both with your alcohol inks as well as your watercolors. You also get a mini pot of gilding flakes, these are called sun-kissed copper, and they are not the normal gilding flakes, these are quite chunky, they are bigger so they don't fly all over the place. And I will use this product in one of the cards that I share today. You also get a mini crystal drop in bubblegum blush. And if you are a subscriber of this kit, you should have a big collection of these Nouveau drops by now. And you see all the products in this kit come in these gorgeous browns and copper shades, as well as pink, that everything goes nicely together. Now this is a glitter pot. The color is chestnut brown. And this is not a mini pot, it's the normal size, so you get lots of product. And if this pot of glitter is not enough, here is one more pot with glitter. These are actually confetti flakes and the color is chestnut brown. Again, you get a big bottle, so lots of product in here, and I like to mix these flakes with other elements on my shaker cards. You also get a glitter marker. This is strawberry bonbon. If you are a subscriber of these kits, you probably have more colors in your stash, so here is one more for your collection. Now remember that you can color with this marker, but you can also apply some on your glass mat and pick it up with a brush. This is water-based, so it can be used as watercolor with glitter. Now moving on, you get two bags with rings. One is in classic bronze color and the other one is in antique brass, and you get six of each color. They open up really easy, and if you are into bookmaking, then you will use those a lot. Now just like always, you get a sticker, and let's take a look on the dies and the stamp set for this month. This is the Memento stamp set and it comes with five stamps. You get a lot of sentiments, and this kit is actually called Memento Bookmaker, which means that you can use the dies and the stamps and the rest of the things for making books, but I'm going to show you that it is more versatile. A Time to Treasure can be used on Christmas cards, on fall cards like I will be sharing today. You also get True Friendship Lasts Forever, perfect for friendship cards, as well as And So Our Adventure Begins, which can mean a new baby, a wedding, so many different ideas there. And now let's take a look at the dies. There are 15 dies included in the die set. Great value for money. If you are a beginner on bookmaking and album making, then this is perfect for you, but it can be used equally for creating cards. So this is the big die that will create your front cover and the back cover of your book. Instead, I'm going to show you how you can use this die to create a shaped card, and I will make only cards today, just to show you that this is quite versatile and you get lots of dies. Now, you also get these rectangle frames that fit inside the bigger one. These are great because they give you lovely panels for embellishing cards, and they have lovely stitching and lovely details on the edges. Now, if you want to make a book and you need holes for using your rings, then you can place this here in the gap. And if you want to see how to put together an album, then you can go to the Tonic Studios website. I'm sure they will post lots of tutorials on how to make them. Instead, I am going to show you today how to make cards, since I am a card maker. Now, you also get two sentiments to die cut, and also what I absolutely love about this kit is that you get these corners. As many dies as I have, I didn't have corners to embellish my cards, so I'm super happy because I get 5 different designs in this set. Plus, you also get this tiny little die that cuts out slits. This is meant actually to tuck inside photos, but for a card maker it's perfect for creating gift card slits. And another thing that I'm super happy about is that you get 3 different dies that cut out tabs. All the tabs are going to end up in a different position. These are great, of course, for making albums, but they are great also for creating cards, and I will use them today in one of my cards. And you also get lots of cardstock. This is a mirror card in rose platinum. This is a specialty paper called Blush Heartbeat. Here is a gorgeous cardstock called Ivory Toile. This is ivory white and a gorgeous cinnamon silk. Love this texture, gorgeous cardstock. This is glazed chestnut, a pearlescent one. This is really textured and soft, one of their specialty papers, which is called Soft Leather Jacket. And finally, you get Express Brown and craft card. This actually has 2 different colors. You can use either side depending on your project. So let's use this kit to create cards. I will be combining these beautiful papers from the kit, and I absolutely love this one. This is perfect for wedding cards, and I'm going to do just that. I'm going to use the big die, which is meant to cut out the covers of a book, and I'm going to cut it out from this cardstock twice, and with this panel I'm going to cut out once from the ivory. Now, I end up having these 2 shapes, which I'm placing one on top of the other. These are going to create my card base, but I need to use my paper trimmer to cut out the bottom of those shapes. Now, I'm going to use my scoring board and I'm going to draw a line where those 2 slits are at the top of my cutout. I'm going to fold this flap, and this is where I am going to add at the back some tape adhesive, and I'm going to stick those cutouts together to create my card base. I absolutely love the shape of it, so I'm just going to embellish it and turn it into a wedding card. I'm going to use this decorative die and the scraps that I have left over from cutting out my card base, and I cut out 2 different corners that I'm going to use and embellish my panel. I'm using my Nouveau Deluxe glue at the back, and I'm going to stick them in 2 opposite corners. Of course, you can cut out 4 different corners if you like to embellish all the corners. Here is how it looks. It works either way, vertically or horizontally, and all you have to do is to add the sentiment at the center. Now, I went with a die cut that I had in my stash that writes best wishes, and I think it's perfect for a wedding, and you can see that it works either way. I used foam squares at the back to stick that panel on top of my card base. I'm going to finish off my card by tying a ribbon, and I love that the design of this card base has those slits at the top, which are perfect to tuck my ribbon inside. I'm going to tie a bow, and my card is ready. Now, of course, on the inside you can write your message, but I'm also going to show you how you can use that tiny little die to cut out slits. So all you have to do is to just place it on the corner of a panel, and this is going to cut out all those little flaps where you tuck in your gift card. Then you can stick this inside, making sure that you leave enough space for your message. For my next card, I used a smaller rectangle die to cut out this panel. I have placed it inside my stamping platform, and I'm going to stamp one of the sentiments from the kit using the ink pad that was included. And I'm using the textured side of this cardstock, so I need to stamp it a couple of times. I created my card base out of the brown pearlescent cardstock in the kit, and I'm going to create some embellishments. For that I'm using just a scrap piece of paper, which I am covering up with double-sided tape. I am removing the top, and now my surface is all sticky. I'm going to bring in a scrap piece of paper to work on top of it so that I don't create a mess, and I'm going to apply on top my flakes. I'm using my fingers to spread them around. The flakes are going to stick on top of the adhesive, and you can also use a brush to move the flakes around and to remove the excess flakes. You will end up with a lovely shiny panel that the color is not flat, it will have some variation of color. And I'm also going to combine it with the dies from kit number 12 to cut out some leaves. Of course, if you don't have the kit and you are not a subscriber, you can use any dies of leaves that you have, or even cut out your own shapes with your scissors. And it's actually a great idea to run this panel through your die cutting machine, because all that pressure is going to blend the flakes with the paper completely. I also used my brown cardstock to cut out the shadows of those leaves. Again, the dies are from the same kit, which I think is number 13. And I'm going to put everything together. Then I will decide where I want these leaves to go and stick them down by using my foam squares at the back. This is a great fall card, and I think the sentiment matches perfectly the idea here. And another idea is, instead of using tiny little leaves like I did here, you can use a big leaf on the center of your card as the main focal point, and of course cover it up again with those flakes to give it a gorgeous shine. Now for the next card, I want to demonstrate how to use the expanding mousse. So all I did was to use a stencil from my stash, and I have placed it on top of a panel. I also made sure that the stencil is nicely secured, so I used some purple tape at the back. And now I'm going to apply my mousse by using my spatula. The mousse is nice and soft, and it spreads out just like butter. So you can apply it completely flat with your fingers or your brush, as I showed you in the beginning of the video, but of course you can apply it through a stencil to create more texture. Now if you leave it, it's going to dry as it is, nice and shiny, but if you use a heat gun on top of it, then it's going to start bubbling up, and it's going to create a lovely texture, completely different than what you get if it is air dry. I don't know if you can tell from the video, but here is a close-up photo on how it looks when you finish heat setting it. So to play with your mousse that comes in the kit, just use any stencil that you have at home and heat set it. And then I'm going to create a very simple card here. I used foam tape at the back of my brown panel to stick it on top of my card base, and now I'm just going to stick a die-cut sentiment. And a lovely idea is to add some gems to embellish your card in different areas of your stencil design. So here I found a place where it would look great, and I'm going to stick them down. Now this is a very versatile card, as it can be used for any occasion, and I love that you can hand it out to both men and women. And I hope it gives you some ideas on how you can use your expanding mousse with the stencils that you already have in your stash. Now, can you see in this panel how I have still that embossed detail, although I ran it through my Big Shot, which is perfect. Now, I'm also going to use the three dies that cut out those tabs, and I'm going to cut out panels using these two papers that I have on my screen right now. So I'm going to put everything together now. You can see I have different panels with different flaps, and I do have another one somewhere around here that will pop in my screen in a bit. And as an example, I'm going for a completely different style of cards that I normally do. And all I'm doing is placing those panels one on top of the other. I'm not trying to align them, I just want them to look completely random. And I also found that at the back of those embossed papers, tape runner doesn't work, so make sure to use either white glue or some double-sided tape like I did here. Now I have these three tabs exposed, which is a great place to add sentiments or just stamp them on top. I'm going the easy way, so I'm just going to add some stickers. This is going to be a birthday card and I'm choosing stickers that have something to do with that. So I'm sticking one that says let's eat cake, another one celebrate, and the last one that says make a wish. All these come from the occasions booklet by Tim Holtz, which is old and I think it is discontinued, so I cannot link it. But this design gives you an idea of how you can use tabs on top of a card. Now on top of this design, all you need to do is to add a focal point. I decided to go with flowers. These are really dimensional flowers by Prima, which I don't normally use, but I told you today I'm going for a completely different style of card. I will link to the flowers that I'm using. They are actually on sale right now, but you can use any dimensional flowers that you probably have on your stash, or you can even use dies that you may have to create your own flower, or even stamp a flower, cut it out and stick it there. So many options to create similar cards. Now for the flowers, since they are so dimensional, I used my glue gun to stick everything down. And since this card has so much bulk, obviously this is not a card that I would send out through the mail. Instead, this is a birthday card that I will hand out to one of my close friends on their birthday. I'm finally using my blending tool with what's left on it. This is the one that I'm using with my Distress Oxide inks, just to add a touch of brown on the edges as well as to get rid of that bright white on my stickers. And finally I'm adding some dots with the mini Nouveau Troops that was included in the kit. And you can see how that color matches perfectly the color of the cardstock. And that concludes the last card for today. I hope you had fun and you got inspired as we explored all the products included in the Tonics Craft Kit number 15. I hope I gave you some ideas on how you can use the products included. As always, you will find links down below to everything I used, and if you want to get the kit and you are not a subscriber, then move fast. These kits are great value for money, so they sell out really quickly. Thank you all so much for watching and I'll see you next time.